Lab Mixed Patty. That looks good. Ah, hello! Welcome back to iKids to You Online. I was just checking out all our awesome prizes. Prizes that we want to give to you when you fill in your action packs. Follow our videos. It's going to be awesome. Now, some of the things coming up this week, we're going to do our crazy game. We are going to have awesome worship. We're going to do some teaching. And you're going to follow along with your action packs, aren't you? Yeah, so come on, let's stay tuned for a great episode. Are you ready? Are you game? Well, we got a cool challenge for you. We got another boys versus girls challenge. So let's see who's gonna win the Oreo challenge. Watch this.
Are you ready to win?
Goodness, that was so bad. They both couldn't do it. We've had heaps of kids win that challenge at Kids, haven't we? Oh, well, no winners today, but it doesn't matter. Guess who's a winner? You're a winner.
Wasn't that fun, guys? Well, we're going to continue with our fun today by praising and worshipping our all-powerful, all-loving God. So right where you are at home, I want you to stand up to your feet. We're going to dance together. Come on, I can see you. Stand up to your feet. Let's do this.
Hello, everybody. My name's Maddie. Are you ready to worship? Let's go. Stand up on your feet, everyone. Make sure you've got enough room to worship. I want to see you dancing, moms and dads.
When I thought it was over, you came through. When I wanted to let go, you held on. Your promises kept me through it all. Every word you have spoken will stand strong. There's nothing you can do to bring in the breakthrough. While I wait, I will praise you. Gotta trust you. When my eyes couldn't see it, my heart knew. You're the one I can count on. You stay true. Every step of my journey, I'll trust you. And no matter what happens, you are good. It's not
your mind victory. Hope is rising.
faith is forcing it to me. I will shout it to the heavens, Jesus, you're my victory. God, I trust you. There's nothing you can do to bring in the breakthrough. While I wait, I will praise you. God, I trust you.
Here we go.
So I will dance like it's going. Oh, 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 oh.
Worship. That was so good. We have such a great worship team, but you know what? Even more so, we have such a great God. Now, we're about to get into our teaching, so quick, go get your action packs, get your pencil cases, come and sit on down because we are going to watch our video right now.
Stories of the Bible. Joseph forgives. This is Joseph.
Hey!
Who was the son of Israel and Rachel. But he had 11 brothers who hated him and sold him into slavery. After being put in jail, Joseph told of the future of Egypt when he interpreted Pharaoh's dreams, and Joseph found favor with the Pharaoh. The Pharaoh made Joseph a leader in his kingdom. Just as Joseph had told the Pharaoh, Egypt had 7 years of abundance. Then the 7 years of abundance came to an end, and the 7 years of famine began. Just as Joseph had said. But the Egyptians had food to eat because Joseph had planned for the famine. There was famine in all the other lands, and many came to Joseph to buy food. There was even a famine in the land that Joseph came from. So when Israel heard that there was grain in Egypt, he sent his sons to buy some.
Yeah!
But Israel did not send Benjamin with the others. Because he was afraid that harm might come to him. When Joseph's brothers came to him, Joseph recognized them. But he pretended to be a stranger. So Joseph decided to test his brothers. He had his interpreter tell them to send for Benjamin, who had stayed home. And then he threw his brothers in jail for 3 days. On the third day, Joseph let all but one of the brothers take grain to their starving households with the instruction to bring Benjamin back. But Joseph provided for his brothers' journey and gave them grain and silver. The brothers did exactly as Joseph instructed, as they were scared that God was punishing them for what they had done to Joseph so many years before. They traveled home to their father's house, then back to Egypt. Now that he had seen that they brought Benjamin, Joseph was overwhelmed, so he released the brother who was still in prison. But Joseph decided to play one more trick on his brothers. He sent the brothers away but told his servant to hide his silver cup in Benjamin's bag. Then Joseph told the servant to go after the brothers and retrieve the cup. The brothers hadn't traveled far before the servant stopped them and accused them of stealing the cup. Joseph could no longer control himself before his attendants. He made them leave so he could be alone with his brothers, and he told his brothers who he really was.
Ta-da!
He told them of his life and all he had experienced, and he forgave them for what they had done. God was with Joseph and took care of him and showed him favor.
No, but remember a couple weeks ago, I mentioned how much I love beef jerky and you guys were gonna bring some, but you didn't? No beef? Okay, gosh. Oh, hey everybody, welcome back, Kurt here. Have you ever wanted to get back at someone? Maybe they forgot to bring you one of your special gifts, or maybe they did something really mean, or they wronged you in some way, or maybe even they just failed to apologize and say sorry for a mistake that they had made. Tim had worked really hard on his project for the science fair. He got to school early to set up his presentation, making sure that everything was just right. And when he came back later, he found that someone had broken one of his rockets. In the story from the Bible about Joseph, we learned that Joseph was sold into slavery by his brothers because they were jealous of him. And while he was a slave in Egypt, Joseph's life briefly improved before things got even worse. He went from being a well-respected servant to a prisoner. Even though he hadn't committed a crime or done anything wrong at all. And while in prison, Joseph interpreted the dreams of two of his cellmates. Remember, we talked about this last week, that news eventually reached Pharaoh about Joseph's prophetic ability. At this time, Pharaoh was troubled by a specific dream of his own that he was having. He called Joseph to his court and he ordered him to tell him what the dream meant. Joseph predicted a dream of great wealth in Egypt, followed by years of poverty and people going hungry. Pharaoh freed Joseph from prison and placed him in a position of great power. Eventually, the years of wealth ended and the hard times began, just the way Joseph had predicted. Far away from Egypt, Joseph's brothers were struggling to feed themselves because they were in the middle of this time of hunger. Jacob told his sons to travel to Egypt to buy food. When they arrived in Egypt, Joseph recognized his brothers, but they didn't recognize him. He probably couldn't believe it. The brothers who betrayed him showed back up in his life all these years later. He had the perfect opportunity to punish them, to get revenge on them for what they had done to him. Tim's situation might have been smaller than Joseph's, but he was understandably upset after working so hard on his science project. Like Joseph, he couldn't be blamed for wanting to get back at the person who had wronged him. But that's not what Joseph did. Instead, Joseph invited his brothers to have a meal with him. He asked them questions about their home and about their father. With them was Jacob's youngest son, Benjamin. Joseph knew that Benjamin was Jacob's favorite son. After dinner, Joseph secretly placed an expensive silver cup in Benjamin's bag. He then had his men search the bag, and when they found the silver cup, Joseph accused Benjamin of stealing. But the purpose of his plan was not to get revenge. It was to test his brothers to see if they had changed over all these years. The brothers begged Joseph not to punish Benjamin. They told him that their father had already lost one son and he could not bear to lose another. Joseph could tell that his brothers were sorry for what they had done to him all those years ago. And in that moment, he chose to forgive them. revealing to them that he, in fact, was their long-lost brother. Rather than punishing his brothers, he celebrated how God had reunited their family. Every human being is sinful. Sin is when we simply do something that we know is wrong. I do that, you do that. Even Joseph was a sinner. Joseph did things that he knew he shouldn't. We all do things that are wrong, and we deserve to be punished by God for those things. But because God loves us, he chooses to forgive us for our sins. Like Joseph's brothers, however, it is important that we show that we're sorry for our sin. Tim recognized that he makes mistakes too. And rather than punishing someone else for their mistakes, he chose to model God's forgiveness. Forgiveness is a wonderful gift, but sometimes we struggle to accept it. Maybe it's because we feel like we don't deserve it. And we might be right to think that. There's nothing we can do to earn God's love or his forgiveness. But just because we can't earn these things doesn't mean we shouldn't accept them. They are the greatest gifts we'll ever receive. In fact, this week, if there is anybody here who wants to receive God's gift of forgiveness, we have a special prayer that your leaders will walk you through. Accepting God's forgiveness was the very best decision I ever made, and I hope you feel the same way. That's all we have for you this week. I hope to see you again next week as we take a look at our final episode on our series on Joseph. Have a great week.
That was such a good message, but hey, the learning doesn't stop there. Make sure you get your table talk topics and have a chat with Mum and Dad around the table sometime this week.
The Bible tells us that God loves us so much, and that includes every single one of you. And today I want to let you know that God wants to be closer to you than a brother. He wants to be closer to you than any friend you've ever had before. And the way you can do that is by praying a prayer and asking Jesus to be your best friend. And I'd love to do that with you today. Maybe you've said this prayer before, maybe you've never prayed this prayer before, but today, wherever you are, I'd love you to pray this prayer with me. Why don't you say these words after me? Dear God, I thank you for loving me. And today I ask you to be my best friend. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, if you prayed that prayer, whether you've done it before or whether you just prayed it for the first time today, why don't you tell someone at home that you made that decision to have Jesus as your best friend?
kids. Thank you for joining us today. It's been so fun hanging out. Continue to follow us on our Instagram page. Follow us on YouTube. Do your action packs and your challenges. Send them in because we want to keep sending you prizes. It's been so much fun. We will see you right here next week.
Kids, there are three things we need to do today before we start our lesson together. Why don't we do these three things together? Number one, find a spot so you can see, turn on your listening ears so you can hear, and close your eyes so we can pray. Now, why don't you say this after me? Thank you, God, for this day. Thank you, God, for my family. Thank you, God, for my home. Speak to me today. Amen. Excellent. Now, why don't we open our eyes and let's watch today's lesson.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, friends, I hope I didn't scare you, because it's time to go on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Now, friends, pretend to put on your adventure bags.
Whee! Hi, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Hi, Shine. What question are we finding the answer to today?
It's a good one. What do you say when you're afraid?
Shine, do you know picture passes that will help us find the answer?
I sure do. Open your trunk and I'll give you some clues.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It reminds you of nighttime.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Great job, friends! It's the moon! Catch it in your adventure bags! Okay, Shine, what's next?
This one is something a warrior holds when he's fighting.
Friends, which one do you think it is? Friends, you're great guessers! It's the shield! Catch it in your adventure bags.
Now for the last one. This is what you buckle up with in the car.
Which picture pass is Shine talking about? Friends, you got it. It's the seatbelt. Catch it in your adventure bags. Friends, count with me. One, two, three. Yep, they're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bags together.
Now it's time to fly.
Whoa.
Shine, I keep thinking about the question you asked me. What do you say when you're afraid?
I know the Bible has a story that can help.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
A roaring rescue. That's in the book of Daniel in the Bible. Daniel had to do something really scary.
I wonder what he did when he felt afraid. Let's find out.
God's people disobeyed him, so he let their enemies take them into captivity. They destroyed Jerusalem and carried away many of the Jews to their own country, Babylon. Daniel was one of the Jews in Babylon. He trusted God and prayed to him 3 times a day. God blessed Daniel, and he became a powerful leader in that country. Some leaders were jealous of Daniel, so they made a new law. People could only pray to King Darius. Whoever disobeyed would be thrown into a lion's den. Darius agreed. Daniel still prayed to God and was arrested. Darius was sad. He liked Daniel. He realized he'd been tricked, but couldn't change the law. Daniel was thrown to the lions. The lions roared and crept up to Daniel. Then an angel arrived. It was God who sent him. The angel shut the lions' mouths. Daniel spent the night there unharmed. At daybreak, Darius went to see if Daniel was alive. "God sent an angel to save me," Daniel said. The king was thrilled. Daniel was pulled out of the den. Then King Darius had Daniel's enemies thrown into the den. The lions gobbled them up. King Darius told everyone in his kingdom to honor Daniel's powerful living God.
Shine, Daniel must have been really afraid of that scary lion's den.
But Daniel didn't let fear stop him. He prayed and trusted God.
Oh yeah, God helped Daniel say goodbye to fear and do what he needed to do.
It sounds like you might know the answer to the question. What do you say when you're afraid?
I think I do. Goodbye, fear. God is here.
Does Guy the Bible Guy know a Bible verse about that?
Frizzlin' razzles. I bet he does. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Come on.
Oh, hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy. I'm looking for a Bible verse about a special question.
What's the question?
What do you say when you're afraid?
I know what to say. Goodbye, fear. God is here. And I do know a Bible verse about that. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, listen to what God says in Isaiah 41:13. The Lord your God says to you, do not fear, I will help you.
Friends, say it with me.
Isaiah 41:13.
Isaiah 41:13.
The Lord your God.
The Lord your God.
Says to you.
Says to you.
Do not fear.
Do not fear.
I will help you.
I will help you.
Great job, friends. Now say the whole verse with us.
Isaiah 41:13. The Lord your God says to you, do not fear. I will help you.
Friends, you got it.
Guy, does that mean God will help me every time I'm afraid?
He sure will. Whenever you feel fear, you can pray and trust God.
There is a time when I need God's help and I feel afraid. I think I have a picture pass about it. Friends, which picture pass reminds us of the nighttime? Super job, friends! It's the moon. I feel afraid when it's really dark at night.
Emily, you can still pray and trust God at night, too.
You're right. God will help me say goodbye to fear, so I don't have to be afraid.
Yep, that's what God promises in my favorite book, the Bible.
Thanks so much. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on.
To the left. Now to the right. Faster. Whoa. Nice shot.
Thanks, Mr. Stone. Mr. Stone, catch this.
Wow. What a kick, Blinky.
Don't worry. I'll go get it. Ah! There's a spider over there.
What's wrong with spiders?
I'm super-de-duper scared of spiders. Will you please go get the ball for me?
I would if I had legs.
Oh, come on, Mr. Stone. What am I gonna do?
You'll have to go get the ball even though you're afraid of spiders.
But Mr. Stone, can't God just make the spider go away so I won't be scared anymore?
God doesn't always take spiders away, Blinky. But God will always help you when you're afraid. You just need to pray and trust him.
So if I pray and trust God, he'll help me? I don't need to be afraid?
That's right.
Well, okay. Friends, will you please pray with me? Thanks, friends. Let's do it. Dear God, please help me get that ball, even though there's a scary spider over there. In Jesus' name,
amen. Are you ready, Blinky?
Yep. God's gonna help me do what I need to do.
You did it.
You bet I did. Goodbye, fear. God is here.
Hi, friends. When I feel afraid, like when it's really dark at night, I can pray and trust God. He'll help me say, goodbye, fear. God is here. Because God says in his Bible, Isaiah 41:13, the Lord your God says to you, do not fear. I will help you. Wowie zowie, I think I hear Mr. Music. Come on, let's go. Hi, Mr. Music.
Hi, Emily. What are you finding out on your Bible adventure?
What do you say when you're afraid?
I know. Goodbye, fear. God is here.
That's right. Mr. Music, does God help you say goodbye to fear?
Yes, he does. When I feel afraid, God helps me fight fear so I can do what I need to do.
Fight fear? I think I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass does a warrior use when they're fighting? That's right, friends. It's the shield. A shield protects a warrior while they fight. But how do you fight fear?
You've got to pray and trust God. I know a song about that. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Okay, friends, here we go. Spooky spiders.
Oh, no.
Scary snakes. Caves and cobwebs. Is God here?
I'm scared.
God is with me.
God is with me.
He's always here.
He's always here.
And God helps me.
And God helps me
to fight fear.
To fight fear. Sing with me, friends.
I can pray.
I can pray.
And trust in God.
And trust in God.
God helps me.
God helps me.
Do what I need to do. I can pray.
I can pray.
And trust in God.
And trust in God.
God helps me.
God helps me.
Do what I need to do. So spooky spiders.
No big deal.
Scary snakes.
So what?
Caves and cobwebs.
I'm not scared.
Is God here?
Yes, he is.
God is with me.
God is with me.
He's always here.
He's always here.
And God helps me.
And God helps me.
To fight fear.
To fight fear.
I can pray.
I can pray.
And trust in God.
And trust in God.
God helps me.
God helps me.
Do what I need to do. I can pray.
I can pray.
And trust in God.
And trust in God.
God helps me.
God helps me.
Do what I need to do. That was great. Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing.
For you, I clap and lift my hands. Oh God, for you, I sing and dance.
When I
watching over me. He keeps me safe. He loves my family. Jesus, I trust.
I just heard Shine. Friends, did you hear him too? Aha! I did hear him! Hi, Shine. We've had a great Bible adventure.
Do you remember the answer to the question, what do you say when you're afraid?
Yup, yup, yuppers! Friends, say it with me. Goodbye, fear. God is here.
Wait, and what Bible verse did Guy teach you?
Friends, let's say it for Shine. Isaiah 41:13. The Lord your God says to you, do not fear. I will help you.
God will help you. What did you find out about the picture passes?
The moon reminds me of when it's dark at night.
Emily, are you afraid of the dark?
Not anymore, because God helps me say goodbye to fear when I pray and trust Him. The shield helps remind us that we can fight fear with God's help.
And when God helps you fight fear, nothing can stop you from doing what you need to do.
Yeah, not even spooky spiders or scary snakes. And then there's the seatbelt. What's that got to do with fear?
What do you use a seatbelt for in a car?
It buckles me into my seat, nice and safe.
God keeps us safe too when we follow Jesus. We don't have to be afraid.
Yeah, that's right. I can say goodbye to fear because God's always taking care of me.
Now let's pray that our friends can say goodbye to fear too.
Okay, friends. Bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, help us to trust that you are always with us to help us. We do not have to be afraid of anything. In Jesus' name, amen. Flying lions, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Wasn't that wonderful? We learned so much about our great God. See you next time.